Hi everyone, my name is Rutinder Labana. I'm a solutions architect at SqlDBM. Today we'll be covering Snowflake tags. As you can see, you can run the following SQL script to see which tags you have within the following schema. Now let's see how you can bring them in and visualize them within SqlDBM. So I have a project created called Snowflake Tags, and I'm just going to reverse engineer the schema that we just saw earlier. Select the right database, return to a schema, click apply, and now we'll see the DDL script created for that specific schema. As we can see, all the tags that we had seen earlier are being represented here. Once we click upload, on the left-hand side, we'll see a quick preview in terms of all the objects that will be brought in. So we can see over here all the tables, views, and the tags that we'll be bringing in into our project. Once we click import, visualizations for all of those objects will now be created. We can organize them automatically rather than having to spread them out. Once a tag has been added to an object, those will be represented with this icon. If we navigate to Database Explorer over here, we'll be able to expand the tags and see all the tags that exist within the specific project. So we select either the tag icon or the tag, the tags property will appear on the right hand side. Over there, you'll be able to see what schema the tag belongs to, what type of values it has, and you can also color coordinate that. As you color coordinate your tags, those colors will be represented and will be seen within the diagram itself and on the left hand side panel. You can also filter your diagrams based on tags. So if we wanted to see all the objects that contain tag underscore one, we can click add, and all the other objects that don't meet that criteria will simply disappear. Now we can bring everything in. So what we see over here are the tags that we brought in during the reverse engineering process. If you want to create new tags, you will be able to do that by clicking on the three dots, selecting create new, and you can give it a name. We'll give it some optional values, and we'll also call it coordinator. Once that is done, in order to assign a tag to a specific view or an object, you'll be able to click on the three dots and select a specific tag. You can add multiple tags to an object as well. Any tags that have been applied to an object will be represented with a check mark here. If we navigate to our database documentation page, over here you'll see a list of all the objects that exist within the project. And as we scroll down, if any of those objects have a tag assigned, you'll also be able to see those tags here. So what we have gone so far is how you can bring in your existing tags, where you can visualize them, how you can organize them by color coordination, how you can filter out your diagram based on different criterias, and how you can create a tag. The next thing we'll go over is how you can generate a forward engineering script with your tags. So we'll generate statements, and as you can see, the tags will be part of your DDL. That way you don't have to worry about adding them manually later on.